الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم
والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله وما بعد ونامي دا brothers and sisters السلام عليكم to one all ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته I say thanks to Allah and I tell and thank you for bringing me back to Unam safely after Allah don't go make us see and I fulfill the fifth pillar of Islam just like any other brother we Allah be don't get a chance there and we pray back for the one that we not get a chance may Allah open their way may Allah make them go fulfill this commitment may Allah guide we and protect we when I meet our brothers and sisters always when they start the speech of me on bayan or any talk or any topic I they always ask Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for protect me and from the shaitan when I the plain enemy of mankind and I begin the Allah in him, we get the mercy of this world and the mercy of the next world. And I the further tell and thank you for guide me to an Islam. If not to Allah in guidance, me and you not for become Muslims. And I the bear witness which when I say no other God no the we get right for worship and we not go be troubled yom al-qiyamah except Allah and Muhammad, peace be upon him, nine the last messenger we Allah don't send to mankind. And then a new servant. Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. After a few weeks, we are not the Alhamdulillah, Allah make all the dua we make, and I make on behalf of myself and my own family and Utunam, and the one that I mention, the one that I don't mention, but I always make and say, Ya Allah, the one that you know, we me know, the one that I don't know, and the one that they ask for dua, the one that not even ask for dua, or even the one that not get chance for letting. Get people that really make dua for their own behalf at Tinaf na Haram, inshallah, by the will of Allah SWT, Asiyam. And at Tinaf Mount Arafah, Asiyam, and at Tinaf na all the places them. We necessary for lay, Allah say, Afidu min haitu afada nas, when I go sign in water man in the go, long ago complete the necessary rite of the heart, and Allah make all a completer by the will of Allah SWT. May Allah answer me. And the one that we all go, and the one that we don't go before, may Allah accept we all.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, Islam, na idin, na the only way of life where human being the whole on this world we go become successful for us. Success in material success, not to even call success. The success when Allah SWT give the knowledge of the deen. He guided you to Al-Islam, that the best gift we don't ever give to you as a man, as a human being. So hold on to that. Hold on to your deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because now it only means of your survival. Now you means for your own salvation. So not make a joke. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't warn me several times in the Quran, and he don't give me the main menu or the manual where we for use where we go work out your life successful under this earth. So may Allah guide me and protect me. I remember before I set off for Hajj, na Umrah I first make, but anything where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we want to do something, it make lay something happen. For there you get to what you want to. When Allah one called me in the haram, it makes something happen in my own life. And also a sort of sadness and a grief towards me loved ones, them who I miss, where Allah don't take. Where I know say any one probably one day Allah will must call you, all get for return to Allah. So within that grief, Allah make he put these words in your servant, he must say, where you know we suggest you go Umrah. And I go Umrah. And at Tinab, na the haram, and the very spots, all the spots them, including Babul Murtazama, and also the Hajar Ismail, and all the places them where, then 15 places them where we say, All F-15 president, anytime you go hatch, they are not make, no wait, you know, miss that chance day. Make use of her. And the dua then mustajab, the answerable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah give you back that tawfiq day, just like we give me that tawfiq. So at Tinab, na the very haram, I ask Allah, give me hajj. And I want more umrah, more hajj. But when he called me this year, I begin back with umrah, then I do the hajj. So this that they tell say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Uduni astajibu lakum, call upon me, I go answer now. And if you ask, but in the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tell me, say, in the very close to me, and he they answer the call of we, the caller said. And even the one that went in the heaven and the earth, we were in this planet, and all the other planets, yes, alu man fi samawati wa man fil ard. All the one that went up and below, then they ask for this Allah, Allah say, kulla yomin huwa fi shan. It always na Allah. In power, every day it increase. And Allah in might and in power it increase. In any reduce. And Allah not get no age. As he not get no beginning, neither the force. And in the neither the last and not get for be, he not get any. So in the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, 95 follow, we ask for a favor for anything we go through in life and anything we want, let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do for we. Sometimes you don't set off this journey. You won't go this journey, not get the money, but just ask truly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I pull the make life will succeed to this. I not get this, the make life go through this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I know they left you not answer your call. One sincerity day, and you put yourself down to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you obey in commandment, and you believe, say, when you call, I go answer you. No, say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala go answer you. And inside the haram, I don't miss no chance. And Allah make it so possible that when I did in the haram, both Medina and Mecca, the hotel room where the man in Lidon is sleep, he relax, I prefer for Lidon sleep in a mosque. And when the time reach, like in Mecca, when it reach like 2 o'clock or any hour of the day, I grab and make tawaf. And I make dua on my own behalf, and my own two parents them, and my own family them, and on all the brothers and sisters them. So in the way I mention, only for calling in front of other people them. When I very important people them to me, both brothers and sisters. And the one the way I know able to mention the name, I mention in my dua, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell you, say, la yuminu ahadukum hatta yuhibba li akhihi ma yuhibbu li nafsi. When I know get complete iman, when our faith not go complete, except you like for your brother, what you like for yourself. So brothers and sisters, whatever you go through in your life, whatever goodness you want, first one time for your brother and sister, so that Allah go open your way. May Allah guide me. As brothers and sisters, I'm back from the Hajj, and before I set off this journey, it was once in my life Allah tested me. And he called me to the Holy Land by performing Umrah. From the Umrah, I made a dua on behalf of my problems and also Allah to call me for Hajj, because it's the biggest and the most noblest and valuous, expensive reward that you will not get, any other reward other than Jannah. So Allah answered my call. When I left this year with the groups that I will set off for the Hajj, the first thing Allah blessed me with to do another Umrah than before the Hajj. And alhamdulillah, none of the necessary Hajj rites we are missing. And also in all the points of the Haram, where you can stand and make dua, I did it. Not only for myself, for you as well as brothers, and those that I know, those that I don't know, and even those who never ask for dua and those who ask for dua. And also those who don't have dua for people to pray on their behalf, to make dua on their behalf, I made dua on their behalf. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la yuminu ahdukum hatta yuhiba li akhihi ma yuhibu li nafsi. None of you, your iman is complete except you love for your brother what you love for yourself. And when I was there, I did not embark on the idea of taking photos just because I want to show brothers. But if any photo that you see that leak on social media is only to inspire brothers and sisters, people who are as young as me, or of the same age, or people whom I've been hanging around with, just to inspire them, and I pray on behalf of them for Allah SWT to give them the very chance that He has given me, so that Allah will call them in this place. Because the place that when you go, when you are there, you don't feel stress. You don't think any other part of the world that is existing that there is a stress when you are there, both Mecca and Medina. And alhamdulillah, all the points that I stood, I made dua on behalf of myself and behalf of you brothers and sisters and those that I know and those that I don't know. Some of them I mentioned them by name. Some of them I cannot mention them by name. Even if I take the list, Allah knows them best than me. And Allah knows their problem more than me. So I made dua on behalf of them. And including all the brothers all over the world. Those who are going through problems. So may Allah guide us and protect us. So while people we have the best hotels you can think of, but the best hotels I ever enjoyed there is the hotel in Haram, sleeping on the bare floor of Masjid al-Haram, both Mecca and Medina. Sometimes when I get tired, instead of getting nap in the hotel, I'll go right in the Masjid Nabi, and I lay down, and I get a good sleep, and I wake up, and I do my ibadah, and I do my dua, and go back to the hotel, get something to eat. And also while in Mecca, that's worse because all along I never take a nap in any of the rooms that was allocated to us, especially me. I was sleeping on the floor and I love it. And I will do it again. I will continue to do it again because I love it. Because that's the best position you will be on earth and that's the best moment you will not miss. I did not go there for any shopping and don't expect that when I come, you expect the best of the best of me. But the best that I brought for you is dua. On behalf of you brothers and sisters, may Allah grant answer to my dua for myself and you and those who need this dua most. So brothers and sisters, this is motivational. Sometimes if you go on my Facebook page, I was once live while I was doing tawaf for my doing Umrah 2 days before we are about to depart. I did Umrah for my mother because she has done Hajj before, but I did Umrah for her on behalf of her. So I made a documentary and I show some important part of Masjid al-Haram, especially Safa and Marwa, and going all the way to the Mataf, the places where we go around the Kaaba, and also showing the point and where and where and where, when and how to do all those necessary things. Sometimes you need someone that knows you or that speaks your language so that he will explain to you in a better form. Sometimes what we see on YouTube and other times might not be sufficient, but sometimes some other people, their explanation can able to make us understand a little bit more better than what we can read or hear from others. So also, brothers and sisters, this motivation that I motivated the brothers is not because to congratulate me, and I did not go there to people when I come back to call me Al-Hajj Musa. I'm still Brother Musa. So I'm Al-Hajj. When you are there, they call you Hajj. That's always I say this to people. Ask the brothers that have been there and sisters. When some things are going wrong around in the Haram, or the authorities, security forces, or all those people who are taking care of the masjid, in order to refer you as a guest of Allah, they say Hajj. They say Hajj. If this is wrong, it's Hajj Mamnu, Hajj Haram. Hajj, that's your name. But when you are back from there, you are not Hajj here. Because I'm not a stranger here. I'm a Muqim. I live here and I stay here with my family. But when you are there, you are a guest of Allah SWT. That's what it means. When they say Hajj, it means a guest of Allah SWT. But for us, the Africans, we have this custom or tradition. Sometimes we don't want to, if we used to know someone by name Muhammad or Musa or Ibrahim or Isa, we don't want to call them by their names directly. We say Al-Hajj Musa, Al-Hajj Isa. Well, for me, still call me Brother Musa, I'm still Musa. So there's no difference. The only thing, I fulfill the fifth pillar of Islam and I say thanks to Allah SWT for making it possible for me, and may Allah bless those who contributed for my own for this journey and make it possible for me by the will of Allah. May Allah grant them the best of the best in this world and the hereafter. So I pray also for my parents and also for my own family and your families as well, and brothers and sisters. And I will ask you, brothers and sisters, what will you say when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yawm al-qiyamah? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you good health and wealth, and you have a house, you have a car, but you still waiting and you don't make this trip to make it possible for you to make the fifth pillar of Islam. It might be expensive, but let's check those trips that you've made around the world, and let's check those parties that you've erected and that you've conducted for your family, both your wife marriage anniversary or your children's birthday. Can you put that money together if you have to save it and put it in perspective and give it for the sake of Allah and perform Hajj? That is more better than what you do for this dunya. Because when you bring up your family in an Islamic atmosphere, in an Islamic way, wallahi, when they grow up, they will also do the same thing and they will think about you. And I believe I'm the example here, because my father taught me Islam, and he never taught me all these things that those that came to the West and settled here. Instead of we are celebrating more of Islamic ideology, we celebrating ideology that does not belong to Al-Islam, like birthdays and also like marriage anniversaries. This is not from Al-Islam. Those money that we waste on those things, if we put them together every year or every month, we put aside a little amount of pounds, maybe by a year or two, you will have the amount that you need to perform Hajj. So may Allah give you the tawfiq and give you the strength and make you have the love for the Islam. Because had it not been the love for Islam, I wouldn't have been here. I would have been like any other person. That money that I paid, like £4,600, I would say, let me go and finish my house. I would think about that. But what house can you compare that of the Jannah, when each house of Jannah, each palace of yours in Jannah, is built, not the wall built with sand or mud or cement, it's built of gold and silver and of other gems that you've never seen on this planet. So can you compare that reward and as compared to the ones that you've built here? When, as you pass away, those that love you and those that don't love you will come together and fighting for it, and so they want to have their own share. So why don't you work for your own akhirah? And this is why Allah SWT is asking us, Ya ayyuhal insanu, ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem. O you mankind, what is deceiving you on the path of your Lord? Alladhi khalaqaka fasawwaka fa'adala. He created you, he perfected your creation, and made you look somehow, as he said, ahsani taqwim, the best shape of form Allah has given you. Is that Allah SWT? If you prioritize his love and worship and obedience to him, he will give you what is more than what you are fighting for this dunya. He will give you the thing that first he will give you in this dunya, tranquility in your family, and also houses that you know, if you want houses, he will give you more if you want. And but that of the akhirah, khairun wa abqa, is more better and the best. So may Allah give us that iman. It's not because of money or riches that make people go to Mecca. It's because of iman, and because knowing that one day we'll leave this planet, one day we'll meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Islam is built on five pillars. The first and foremost, when you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's none worthy of worship except him and Muhammad, peace be upon him, his servant, and you must complete the five daily prayer. That makes you a believer. And then you must give zakat. That makes you a true believer. And you must do sawm, that is you fast in the month of Ramadan. That makes you a believer. And the last but not the least, Hajj al-Bayt, and perform Hajj. Liman istata'a ilayhi sabila. This one is exempted. Allah said, the Prophet said, Liman istata'a ilayhi sabila. For the one who can able to pay their own way. It's not compulsory, but some people have the means. They have the way, and they even send one or two or three or 10 people to Hajj. But what about you? أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابَ وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Are you urging people to be kind and do good, and you forgetting about yourself? And if Allah said, count 10 people to go to Jannah, will you forget yourself? La. Allah also said, قُوْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. He said, oh, you believe, قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ, warn yourself, wa ahlikum, and your family. It did not say one people, it said one yourself. I myself that is saying a word or two here, I must warn myself, put something into practice before I warn any other person else. Whether my wife or my children or any family member. So Allah said, warn yourself and your family. Well, about what? About the hellfire. Why the hellfire? وَقُدُهَا النَّاسُ الْحِجَارَةُ. This hellfire that we deny and we thinking is just an imagination or concoction of human imagination, the fear of it, malaik, النَّاسُ الْحِجَارَةُ, human beings and stones. And it's been guarded by malaika, angels. غِلَادٌ شِدَادٌ, they are very hefty, strong, and very strong. They never disobey the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ, and they will do exactly what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded to do. So don't wait. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, Allah will ask you, يَا عَبْ, you beg me, you ask me fervently that if you give me money, if I give you money, I will do such and such. And when Allah give you that money, you started showing some kind of stinginess. وَإِنَّوْ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدِ, human being, he just love goodness, everything the best for himself. And he forget, أَفَلَا يَعْلَمُ إِذَا بُؤْتِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ, he forgot that one day he'll be resurrected when he pass away, when he left this planet and go back to the dust, and Allah will bring him back to life. وَحُسِّلَ مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ, then Allah will access every little bit of good or bad that you've committed on this planet, Allah will access it through your heart and bring you to account. So love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love His house, and your grief and sorrow will go away. A lot of us, why we are overwhelmed with sadness and worries? Because we don't do the right thing. We only chasing the dunya, chasing the dunya. As Allah said, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, it's ألهاكم تكاثر, it's a war to you with your mutual rivalry, competition, building houses, buying cars, marrying beautiful women, having lots of children, حتى زرتم المقابر, until death overtake you and you visit the grave. زور, زيارة, being in the grave is just a visit, it's not forever. Until you visit the grave. How long? 100 years? 1,000 years? 2,000 years? 1 million years? We don't know how long you and I will be lying there. And when each and everyone will be awakened from the death by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then listen what they will say. The non-believer, مَنْ بَعَثَنَا مِنْ مَرْقَدِنَا, who woke us up from this sleep that we are into? Then they will say to him, هَذَا مَا وَعْدَ الرَّحْمَنِ, this is the promise of the Lord of the Mercy, وَصَدَقَ الْمُسَلُونَ, and the messengers have spoken the truth, that there will come one day when you will cease to exist and you will be brought back to alive, and you will be accounted for all your deeds, whether good or bad. So may Allah have mercy upon us and guide us and protect us and give us the tawfiq and the means and the strength and the iman to be able to visit His house. Wallahi, as I said, I left here with one problem also. Probably will never cease to exist. I was having a toothache. And this toothache, wallahi, I bought this TCP long time ago when a sister recommended it from here, from the mercy. She said, buy TCP and put it there. And before leaving, 3 weeks or 4 weeks before, and I've been going through this, I wanted to go to the jeep, to the dentist, to seal that part so that the sensitivity of the pain will go away. So the last day I was about to leave, when I went to the dentist, my dentist is on holiday. And I'll be leaving before he comes back to work. So, alhamdulillah, I set off. I said, tawakkal ala Allah. Even when I was in the flight, the food I was served, I managed to chew on one part. But even that one, I said, everything left in the hands of Allah. The first cup of zamzam I put in my mouth, brother, the second one, before I went to the hotel, like nothing happened up till now. I don't know whether I have a toothache or not. This is one of the miracles Allah SWT did to me. And I was drinking Zamzam like nothing else. Zamzam is my water. Zamzam is my soft drinks. And I guarantee when you go, please let Zamzam be your water. Let Zamzam be everything about you. And make sure that when you drink in Zamzam, make the best of dua. Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'an. Allah, give me a beneficial knowledge, because some knowledge are not beneficial. Or risk and wasian. And also increase me in my wealth. Or shifa min kulli da. Allah, cure me from all disease. And indeed, I used to fly from here to Sierra Leone, fly to other parts of the world. I will have these tissues like this. I will have maybe 3 or 4 packets. They will finish within 2-3 days. But when I went to Haram, that only the first day, the second day, everything just disappeared. This is one of the miracle, another miracle that happens to me. So may Allah accept us and guide us and make everything easy for us. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzah ma yasifun wa salamun ala mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.